Hello, everyone, and welcome to Kernel of Wisdom. I'm Joelle, and today I'm talking about urge surfing. Do you ever get cravings? Really strong urges that you tend to give into? And you know that at least some of those things that you crave aren't really that good for you. Maybe you have the urge for a cigarette, or something sweet to eat, or to eat too much, or for a drink, or for just one more drink, maybe for something even more powerful. Whatever it is that you crave, it is possible to feel the urge and not give into it. So if you want to make some changes, learning how to urge surf can really help. You see, an urge is a feeling or a sensation that happens in the body. Just like any of the other sensations or feelings we learn how to observe in the body through mindfulness. Now, admittedly, urges may be a lot more powerful and really drive us to make impulsive decisions more than other sensations. So they are particularly tricky to deal with, especially because they're tied to some strong habits. And that's why for strong cravings and urges, urge surfing probably isn't enough on its own. You might need to do some work to explore where those urges and cravings come from. When you're ready to change the habit, urge surfing can really help, but it takes some will and some work. Here's what you do. The first step is to spend some time identifying your common triggers. Start by discerning the habit or habits that you want to change. And then journal out the situations or environments where you tend to crave whatever it is. Next is to start getting accustomed to noticing and acknowledging your urges. And you can start practicing this in meditation. As you observe the sensation of the urge, you might notice the tension that arises, the restlessness, the desire to push that feeling away or get rid of it or act on it. See if you can just notice this and whatever else comes up. Just keep breathing into it. This is urge surfing. You just notice the urge, ride the wave of that urge, being with whatever sensations and reactions and chaos it causes within, and then allow it to pass, noting that you didn't actually act on it, you just were able to sit with it. And with all that practice behind you, the next step is just to apply these urge surfing techniques in real life. When you have an urge in real life, it may be stronger than in meditation, but you can still surf the urge just like you did in meditation, helping you get through it in real life. And that's it. It may not always be easy, but it does work with dedication and with practice. And I'll also upload an urge surfing meditation to help, so you can look for that here. Well, I hope that video helped to explain urge surfing and how to do it. If you have any questions, feel free to shoot me a note or post them in the comment box below. Do not forget to subscribe for more mindful videos from Kernel of Wisdom. Have a great day and happy meditating. Bye.